Hello, my name's Brian, call sign is KB8UIP, and today I'll be showing you how to configure digital APRS on the Anytone 878. So let's take a look here. Here's an example of APRS.fi website, and I just transmitted this little APRS packet a few minutes ago from the radio, and I'll show you how I got that all configured. So I've just launched the CodePlug software that comes with the Anytone 878, and this is the screen I've kind of landed on. It's the channel screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Tools and Options and make sure that APRS menu is enabled. So Tools, Options, and it's right here. APRS. This is also where you'd find GPS, Bluetooth, it looks like recording. Incidentally, you'll need GPS enabled as well if you want your position. I'll say OK to that, and that'll make sure that this APRS menu item shows up here. So we've enabled APRS menu item, good. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a talk group for digital APRS, and it's found under digital. Let's resize these a little bit. And talk groups. And this code, there's already a code plug loaded in here, so it already has a lot of information. But if we go to the bottom here, we can see the talk group I created. And this is the Brandmeister talk group for digital APRS in the US. So if you're in Europe or somewhere else, there might be another talk group, but you could use these same setup procedures. So I gave it a name, Digital APRS in this case. I left group call with what it was. There's two choices here. I just left it as group call. And then talk group 310999. And then I hit OK. So I created a... it's here it's listed as talk group, but later on we'll see when we're configuring the channel, it's called a contact. So we've done that. Okay, check. Okay, next we're going to go to the APRS menu that we've enabled, and it's found here under public APRS. And this one sometimes takes a minute to load. You can see it's actually in Chinese right now. Okay, good. So, first thing we're going to do is this top left quadrant area up here, the manual transmit interval. I'm not going to be doing any manual transmission right now. If you wanted to do that, you can always change it, and you can also just change it on your radio easily. I'm going to leave that set to zero. The APRS auto transmit interval, I want to set that, so I'm going to set that to 60 seconds. While you're testing, that's fine. If you want later on, you know, like if you're driving somewhere, you might want to change it to 5 minutes. But since I'm usually hiking and just walking around the neighborhood, I have it set to 60. I have set up roaming on the radio, so I set the support for roaming to on. And then, but that's optional. The fixed location beacon, I have it set to off, and that's because I want the GPS position to be reported. If I wanted a fixed location, like I didn't want a GPS location, I just wanted a fixed location, then I could set that to on and I could set it here, but you know, I'm not going to do that because I want the real position. And then the only other setting on here I'm going to look at is in this right top corner, and that's the digital area. Now you'll notice down here is all the analog APRS, and we're just going to leave that alone because we're not doing that in this video. We're not doing analog, we're doing digital. So the only thing I have to be mindful of here is this this reporting channel, so one. And we're going to leave this set to the default, which is the current channel, which is maximum flexibility. And the reporting slot, just channel slot. And so that makes it flexible for whatever channel we choose in the future. The top group, or talk group we fill in, 310999. And then call type I left as default. You may have noticed on the previous screen when we created the talk group that this actually said group call. I'm just leaving it defaults and it works fine. The last setting I put is 600 milliseconds for the repeater activation delay. So I left that. Or actually I increased it. I think it, by default it's a smaller number. So we're good with that. We'll hit OK. And next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a channel that we can transmit on. So let me go back over here to channel. That'll take a second to load up. Okay, looks like the channels have all loaded up. And so this is a code plug I already have set up. I've already been using my radio. Now I'm just adding a digital APRS channel. So I already have a channel that I use right here in my neighborhood. It goes to a repeater tower. It's DMR capable. So I'm going to use that channel, make a copy of it, and then we're just going to slightly modify it. So let's go find that. It's channel 1103. Go find that channel here. Yeah, I think it's right here. Oops, next page down. So this channel I use right here in my neighborhood. So let me make a copy of that guy. And then I'm just going to paste that at the bottom of the channel list. It should be somewhere right about here. Let's paste it in. So I just right-clicked copied, and I'm right-clicking paste. So right now, this is a working channel. It happens to be for the worldwide talk group on this particular repeater. So right now, this doesn't do any digital APR as anything. It would just talk on the worldwide talk group. So we're gonna modify that a little bit. So we're gonna come up here, we're gonna change the name. So I wanna know which repeater I'm on, so I'll leave that part. But I'll just call this DAPRS. APRS, got it. And I'm just gonna scan through here. I'm leaving. Everything else, you know, the frequency obviously is the same, all the channel, all this is the same. And it says APRS report type. By default, it's digital, but if it wasn't, you know, if it said analog, you can go ahead and change that to digital. Digital APRS push to talk mode. I'm going to leave this off because I don't want to key up and have it send. I just want it to send automatically. And then the report channel I'm going to leave as the default. Also, last thing over here on this right area, it's this little digital area. This contact is world. That's actually the talk group. So we're going to change that to our digital APRS talk group or contact that we created earlier. So it was called a talk group earlier, but here they're calling it a contact. So we'll double click that, and that'll select it. And you can see the name changed here. So the contact now says digital APRS. That's the talk group that we set up 310999. I do note by default SMS confirmation is turned on. I'm just going to leave it, and this default setting for me works fine, so I'm not going to change that. And then we'll just hit OK. So I've created that. And now when I go to use that channel, I want to, you know, I've got over almost 2,000 channels, right? So I'll need that channel somewhere convenient. So I already have a zone called favorites. So we'll go check out my zones here. We're going to add that to our favorite zone. So here's a list of all the different zones I have, primarily by repeater or geographical area. But here's one that I have called Favorites. And inside Favorites, here's all the channels on the left. And the very last one should be the one we just created for digital APRS on that local repeater, DMR-capable repeater. So let's add that to the right. It should be here at the bottom now. Okay, there it is now. So there's the new digital APRS channel that we created that's mapped to the digital APRS talk group, and it's now my favorites. So now when I scroll through the different zones, go to my favorite zone, I'll find it there at the bottom ready to use. So we'll hit OK with that.